Welcome everyone to an arena video. This is Andrea Mengucci. This video is sponsored to you by channelcarbon.com and Ultimate Guard. Alright, thank you, Glacial Fortress, for never leaving Mengu. You have to play Temple of Malice to do the quest? No way. So this weekend. I think I'm gonna play this. Yeah, I can cycle this. Let's try it. This weekend I play Commander, and a friend, one of the people in my pod, one of the friends that I was playing with, just led on Temple of Malice and goes like, your favorite card, and just played Temple of Malice turn one. I loved it. okay, I guess the my control one. I see. Thought Razor. Alright, I want to appreciate Kega for supporting Magic the most with all the alternative art. You are the true champ over there. That is because of you if Oz MPL players still get paid. I'm actually not joking. Thank you, Kega. What did you discard, Kega? Tails End, interesting. Who's my commander? I solved the equation. Who's my commander? My commander is was Urza, although I have two commander decks. One is Omnath and one is Urza. I got Tainted Pact. Am I Cycling Shark? I think so. I think I'm Cycling Shark. Abundant Harvest. No, I'll probably just land go here. I can cycle the trio. Urza, you're excited for the Urza land. Yeah, it's a cool land, right? I don't exactly know how powerful it is. I think people are way overexcited. Just like every Magic the Gathering card ever. Alright, Tassel Oracle resolves. Trigger. And then the Tainted Pact. And now we have to memory lapse the Tainted Pact. And hopefully they don't have the Pact of Negation. Although they always have it, so. Oh wow, they don't have it? This is the actual factual first time ever that I countered their spell and they don't have Pact of Negation. That has never happened in my life so far. It's good that there's a first. Okay, now I'm probably just playing a pig here. The pig! Seems good for vintage? What, the Urza land? You ever play vintage? Oh no, the Urza land is fine in vintage. You don't. Yes, Dirk. It's a Commander Legend. No, sorry. What's it called? It's a Modern Horizon. It doesn't go on Arena, Dirk. Don't worry. Yeah, I think it's time to slap them with Anissa. So, va magnate questa. Brada boom. You can safely ignore that. Exactly, Dirk. That's what they do with Arena. Well, this is the Magic. In Magic, they have like this. They developed this great game that it's just you can have a different target every time, and you can keep them releasing product, and it's just amazing. It's just amazing. Just like this deck that you see in front of you right now. Just amazing. Am I going for Brainstonks? Yeah, I'll just go for Brainstonks. What influence? Obscure, it's very important that you play Nisa here, because you want to clock them. You want to go boom, boom, boom. Stop the clock. Don't stop the clock. I think I'm playing Narset, Parter of the Veil here, instead of the Fairy. My cat is making like the weird sound that usually makes whenever catch something. Gato! Gato! So basically my cat just catches this fake mouse. My cat catches this fake mouse and then it makes like a sound like so you have to watch it, to look at it. And it has the fake mouse in front of him and that's it. You move on. Yeah. So that's the cat. That's it. Actually happens every time. Cat just enjoys picking up the fake cat, the fake mouse, and that moves on. Showing its arms. Exactly. The mouse is stale, like the mouse doesn't move. Also, you know what? Here, I'm just making a memory lapse because this means that my opponent is going to draw another eliminate. Then I have Tails End in my hand, so I want to hope they just die because they're gonna draw the same card. Memory lapse doesn't leave the option of putting on the bottom. No, but the funny thing with my cat is that it always has like the same fake cat. You go Tainted Pact end of turn. It always has the same cat, you know, it's the same fake mouse. No, it's not like a different thing. And you thought some counterspell coming to Modern. Yeah, it was about time, right? I mean, Modern is a format born in 2004. Sorry, with cards made in 2004. That's 17 years worth of cards. Way strongest things than counterspell. What Omnath do you play, Commander? The four color one, the Locus of Creation. You can find the deck pick on Instagram. I posted it. Also on Twitter, but on Instagram it's much easier to browse through photos. Did opponent not read Tails End? Do you think that my opponent also has cards? They maybe have an interaction. They maybe go like, I have this and that. If I draw this and that. Because Tainted Path can put a card into their hand now. Then if they top deck the missing piece, then, if they top deck, for example, let's say they have a Tassa Oracle in hand, right? If they top deck a Tainted. Wait, yeah, if they top deck a Tainted Pact and pick up the Pact of Negation with this Tainted Pact, then they can win. Yeah, their goal is to auto-destroy exactly their library called self-mills. Yes, deck picks. I do deck picks all the time. Actually, I still have to release the old school deck pick. I haven't released the old school deck pick yet. Okay, so they picked up a second Tainted Pact. And now if they top deck, well, they have zero cards in their deck, by the way. They have zero cards in the deck. That's funny. They play the Dream Den of Lurrus. Well, this resolves. And then they cast the Tassa Oracle, and I'm attempting the Tails End on its trigger. Let's see if they have a counterspell for one mana. They do not. Okay. All right, but anyway, Kaiga, that was an impressive game, but I did win the game, so I'm more impressive. Sorry, Kaiga. Next time, though, next time. Allora. So they're just playing straight up blue black. Straight up blue black. Va bene, dai. Oh, Terramorphic Expanse from Jumpstart. Nothing stands out, I wanna say. Negate, Tails End, Narsetete. I'll take a Wrath of God and the Aether Gust. So rest in peace stops Lurrus. But I don't think I care about that, do I? No, I guess I can like have one rest in peace for Yasharn. Yasharn doesn't seem to be great. No Pact of Negation. Oh yeah, they don't have Pact of Negation. That's a good point. Because they couldn't have it in hand either, right? Because okay, this end is great. Buongiorno. Let me charge the computer. Without knocking too many things. I have to decide what to do. I think I want to pick up a. No, actually, I'm just gonna pass here with a forest. Because if I put in place like a distro spell, I want to negate that. Pact of Negation is in sideboard, really? I think I'm just going to negate this. Physically, yeah. I'm just denying my opponent to get to the combo quicker. I can go. Yeah, I'm gonna go Abundant Harvest for non-land here. Classic. Yeah, I'll pass. Then I'll cycle the scattered growth in the turn. Mostly this is in the sideboard, interesting. I would never say that, because like Pact of Negation seems like such a strong card. Wish Claw Talisman would be in it. I mean, you can get multiple cards in your sideboard. I can play one main, one sideboard. If Cosmos, we don't know when it's coming. Not gonna, I don't know. No idea. Am I putting this untapped? When I can like go off next turn, so I certainly need to leave up the tails end. Yeah, actually, let's do this for non-land first. And then I'll do this untapped. Because in case they don't do anything, I'm just cycling the Triome. Maybe I was supposed to... actually, part of me made a mistake. I was supposed to leave the mana up, because if opponent gives me the Wishclaw Talisman, I can pick up an additional counter. Yeah, actually, that was a mistake. Alright, let's hope that doesn't... Professor! Thank you to you too, Professor, for being a very important part of my chat. Very, very, you know, always, you know, pleasure talk to you. Thank you. You can use only Talisman on your turn. Okay, Kyori. Thanks. You have solved the equation there. All right, let's just cast Third Parter Veil here. See what happens. I don't tap the planes though, because I can pick up a Growth Spiral off of this. All right, this is not the resolve, so they do not have a counter in end. Thank you, Magic Arena, for letting me know things. Okay, now I can pick up a commit and a double counter the following turn. I think that's good, right? Yeah, let's get double counter next turn. Yeah. And then Brickete on Dano. They can win now. They can win. I have a Tails End, but they can win. They can always win. I mean, they can win if Pact of Negation exists. So at 4 mana, they can always win if you have only one counter. Exactly, Flynn. Exactly. Alright, would I like to receive a Wishclaw Talisman? What if I Tails End this? Now I'm gonna die. Okay. We're in this. This is the turn, chat. This is the turn. Either they win, or we untap with a good position, I wanna say. That's the Oracle. Resolves. The Tainted Pact. Resolves. E si parte! Here comes the train. I'll try and cast the Tails End, and you know, if they have Pact of Negation, I lose. If not, I win. Choo choo! Please, no Pact of Negation. They didn't have it in the main deck, so maybe they just couldn't craft it. I mean, that deck requires a lot of rares. Choo choo! It's ridiculous, you think, Scabrinator? I think what is more ridiculous is Magic player always wanting cards to be banned. I think that is more ridiculous, especially after only 3 weeks. That is more ridiculous, I believe. Oh, they only want one time bank. Opponent, gotta use it wisely. You have to use it wisely, opponent. Because if they time out, I can just go Tails End, they don't have time to respond. They can win the game. No! Wait. No. No, they have one card in the deck. That's actually not bad, because even if this doesn't work, they aren't dead. But they can win the following turn. Oh! Okay, I have to decide what is the way. What is the way for me? Yeah, let's begin with Narset. I'll just get this. I mean, I don't even need to use the talisman, I think. You can go, opponent. Best of luck. They have zero cards in the deck currently. Hammo! Alright. Yeah, just Oh, back to Wallander. Although it's not a Glacial Fortress, there has been some mistake in the. I did say that, yeah. Must have been some mistake in the deck selection there. All right, let's get back to Feferone Paperone, and we are underway. Baron the Stormcaller. Do I recommend any Esper on control? No, not at all. I would never recommend Esper. I wouldn't recommend Esper to my worst enemy. No, come across obsession. Cazzo. How am I supposed to beat this? Judgy! Judgy, my opponent has played a powerful combo. My opponent has played a two-card combo of that one on turn two. Wizards of the Coast, can you please ban my opponent combo? They turn two killed me. They turn two killed me. I am dead. Why did they stop playing Mono Blue? I guess it's because of. Imagine back in the days, it used to go Teferi, but it used to counter it, so it doesn't even matter. I mean, a combo like this is just so unbeatable. So unbeatable, this combo. Which is the fastest combo magic? Oh, this for sure is the fastest combo magic. Turn one, Cyrus, Storm Teamer. Turn two, Curse Obsession, Spell Pierce. I don't know if you guys remember that, but that was the strongest combo in the world of Magic: The Gathering. And I was always playing my Esperone with full of top lands. Best thing I could have done was turn two, try to raise your turn three to Teferi. Yo, I missed the. Va bene. Land. Ooh, a Breeding Pool. Bonjour, Breeding Pool. Bonjour, Breeding Pool. I mean, thanks to Shark Typhoon, I can double block the Siren. No, don't go Prison Ball. Alright, Anita Baby Shark. Looking to block this Siren Storm Tamer. Can I draw land? Can I draw land? Land. No! I can't even cast that card! Man, that's so bad! Not that I wanted to cast it, so of course not resolving. Bonjour, Breeding Pool. Comment allez-vous? I only knew Comment ça va. I didn't know Comment allez-vous. All right. Hopefully, they don't have this Brazen Borrower. By the way, I drew three Shark Typhoon, which is like the only chance I have this game. I don't have that chance, actually. Oh, I draw an island. I don't even want to cast it. I just want to concede. I don't even want to cast my 5-mana card. A good game is cazzo, pezzo di merda. Alright, Baffling End, Negate, Inarset. How many Nissa do I want to take out? A couple? Wrath of Gods is pretty awful. Look at this. Actually, Tail's End is pretty terrible. County. Yeah, it does, but like, that's so marginal, that Yasharn. The problem with Yasharn is you don't want a second one. You don't want to draw a second one. That's it. Kaylee, they might do that, but no one's winning if they unban cards. Unbanning is generally very risky. Banning is generally very wrong. But, ideally, you don't want to ban anything. Of course, sometimes you have to, but I think we're back at a moment where I think they haven't printed anything too bad for a while. So, I mean, that's why I think it's been like over a month that you haven't seen anyone calling for bans, I want to say. 'Cause This person in the chat right now is like the first one I've heard in a while. Calling for bans. Alright, then I have the Curse Obsession, so they didn't find the 2-card combo. It's a good thing. Yeah, I'll pass here with my Negate up for the top deck of Curse Obsession. Umnath was like, what, 8 months ago? Wow, they did top deck Curse Obsession. It worked! Can't believe it. Can't believe that worked. Am I shocking here? Nah, Dieglaf, I don't want to shock. It's likely that they just bounce my thing, so... I'm just willing to trade. If they happen to not have a Brazen Borrower, I'm fine. Alright. I don't know why, but I'm expecting them to have a Brazen Borrower, so I felt like I don't want to use this 2 life total. I'm gonna go for no land now, because I already have plenty of lands here. 1-0! Shocky shocky! Wow, they do have Brazen Borrower. That's unexpected. I think I'll lapse it. So if I prep, yeah, I think I'm gonna shock here because now I can make a 4/4 shark. It's great to block the 3/1. Mm-hmm. Four. Let's see. They have another Brazen Borrower. I'm okay. Tailsand, yes. Tailsand, Brazen Borrower are all good cards. For them, I mean, if they don't have those, we're. Okay. Okay, I'll start with a Growth Spiral. Yeah, Sharn. And a Baffling End. Hey, yes, it comes from Homelands. It is funny. Am I going to pick up Kyra? You know what, I actually don't want to tap for Negate, I think, at least. Maybe there is something that I should be worried of, but I'm currently not worried of anything. Nice. Let's play Pig. Let's play Kyra. And now passing. They could have Gur's Obsession now. Yes, that's true. And Gur's Obsession will likely put me in a bad spot here. Which kind of splits from Homelands? The Memory Lapse. The fourth set of Magic History, Homelands. Sorry, I don't know why I said that. The 1996. I don't know why I said that. Anyway, let's play Nissa. Who shakes the world? I have a Negate backup counter. It's from 1996, Homeland? Or 1995, maybe. Aether Gust. Do I want to negate this? The problem is that... Like, I attack for 8, you get a 12. Then, next turn, I can attack for, 12, right? I'm lethal next turn. 8x12. So yeah, this is fine. Next turn I have lethal, so there's no difference between negating this now or drawing Nissa later. I'm gonna save negate for like an actual counter magic happening next turn. Unsummon! Okay, now I think I'm negating. Arcane Denial. I'll play that in my commander. Arcane Denial is good in commander, right? Because it's only like 2 people getting value. Alright, Curse Obsession. They need to draw something because I'm lethal next turn. I am a lethal opponent. Can you deal with Mangu lethal? I don't really want to. I don't really love to. You can. You can, in fact. Alright. Time to blow up my whole board state and all the cards in my hand. Oh, Tempest Djinn. That's the only one that brain stonks. Oh. We're alive. We are alive. Mangu 09. Esta no muerto. Eres no muerto. How do you say that? You say. Brainstorm locked? I mean, better bring Brainstorm locked than being dead. The Trickster! Yeah, that's lethal. Good game, opponent! Good game. Good game. Good game, County. Defeat. Oh, first. You go first. See, look at the, you know, you see how this island has the teardrop, right? Opponents play with Quintorius, a little elephant. Oh, opponent really likes Quintorius. They're also mulliganing 1-3. Mango had an extra coffee. I don't really understand why people. It's just that I am like this. I don't have extra coffee. I am. That's just it. Like, sorry that you have to get like all the coffees. Be energetic. I am normal. Die, opponent. Have to go to the bathroom. Play quickly, please. Oh, bravo. Clone Division is a card I did not. A pass here. Mono blue stomps of the control decks. Stomps? Boom. Mono blue doesn't stop much, Pantagana. Mono blue is a deck that, It's a deck that... And I don't even know how to continue. It's mono blue, you know? You have those good draws. You have, like, you're playing mono blue. I don't have much to say about mono blue, really. It's fine, I mean. You can play it. Why did you not go to the bathroom before starting the match? Yeah, I ask that to myself every time. Every time I ask that to myself, Simon. Every time. But then, like, after 1 or 2 minutes, it kicks in and I'm like, oh, it's too late now. Plus, I have a rule that I can only go to the bathroom once per hour. They got crocodiles. You'll have to see your crocs. All right, can I get a land? Muchas gracias. Muchas. Oh, but anyway, pings. I'll do this. On the external planes, I could try. On the external plane, planes Nisa. Yep. Muchas gracias. Troppo ricco, did you see my... Troppo ricco, did you see my YouTube video? Yesterday, for those of you who like to see my collection from time to time, I uploaded to my YouTube channel a video of me showing the three collections. Arabian Nights, The Dark, and Antiquities. And Troppo ricco here in the chat was like the main source of these cards. So, you know, this is most of the reason why I got all of these collections. There's probably one of my... Aspetta un attimo. What do they plan on doing here? A thought seize? I don't want them to seize on my thoughts. I don't want them to seize my thoughts twice. I know, it's fine, right? Oh, no. Yeah, because basically... Troppo ricco came to my house last summer, and he just sold me like all of these wonderful cards, really. opponent cannot combo me next turn. E allora to Magnet Instant. And I could just. And I just starting basically doing all of these collections because of him. Okay, Jimmy. Jimmy, you can discard all my cards now, they don't matter anymore. Just exactly, exactly. Discard. Oh! Call it Tainted Pact. I didn't expect that. Oh, it's gonna take so long now. It's gonna take so long, I might just go to the bathroom. Che palle. We don't talk about that. We don't talk about that. We don't talk about... Wait, did you get... Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Go for it. You watch the game for me? Bathroom break? No, the problem is that... I don't know how long it's gonna take. Seems like every deck now. Apparently, Ace, you if you play against the pact, you have to either do two things. One, you have to complain. Or two is you have to call it for a ban. It doesn't matter the fact that that deck always loses unless when they have literally a 3-card piece on turn 4. But you have to do those things. They're not comboing. They're just taking 2 cards in their hand and then dying to my commit. Or whatever. I mean, if they like top deck pack and kill me, sure, it's fine. I'll lose. I'll lose. I'll lose. If you draw pact, I'm fine. I'll give up. I can cast the Storm's Wrath. It is funny though they're playing Singleton. Like, this makes lots of cards available. Alright. They got the thing, va bene. I'm going to play Brainstorm first. Is that easier trying to shuffle? 1, 2, 3. Thinking. Alright, I'll get rid of the pig, because I drew Fable Passage, so I can get rid of the pig. Get forest. Blue, blue. Archer of the Veil. Minus. Talisand. Oh wow, Giruda. That's been a while. How many cards you have? You have 1 card in your deck. I don't know why I attacked. That was pretty bad. Now I don't have double counter up. Is there a way for me to save myself now? If I go commit, now I think at this point I have made a mistake, and if they draw a pack, they lose the game. Yeah. Right. Okay, opponent, you can have it. You can have this turn. If you draw pact, I lose the game. Oh, pact is in the exile. Ah, vabbè, allora, okay. Tassa Oracle. Resolve. And then Tails End. Okay, so pause sideboard, these 4. I take out Aether Gust, Wrath of God. And now, I think I wanted to bring in one. Did they play Lurrus? They don't play with Lurrus. They don't play with Lurrus. I don't think I want to. Why they don't play with the Rolos? Oh, to play Crackling Drake. And yet, I just sideboard these cards here. Going Aether Gust. Is it like it's better than one Yasharn? Maybe. Is it satisfying, Andres? Okay. I am happy that you found this thing satisfied. Grulagro. But the problem with Young Bonphone Boy is that then you would be playing you Grulagro. Okay? Yeah, maybe they sideboard some red cards in. Like, the second pig is bad. Psychotic Counter, I mean, what do they have to do? Like, sure, they can concede, but better wish. Teach us your ways. I mean, I understand people losing. Like, this, as somebody pointed out, it's like the Mirror Inverter in Pioneer. The Mirror Inverter Pioneer is very similar to this deck. Yeah, it is, Pantagana. People didn't like to play against that deck in Pioneer. But it was probably when the Pioneer was the most popular, so. A Scabbery Knitter, how do you judge what is good for the good or bad for the game? Do you also decide what is good and bad for, like, my understanding of fun? What do you say to the people that need legacy play like Reanimator? Or, I don't know, Doomsday? You think that those people are hurting the game because they play turn one, tier two combo deck? No. They are enjoying the game on a different level than you. And it's important to realize that in Magic, we should, I mean, in life in general, but also in Magic, we should just, if a deck isn't too good, we should just let people enjoy whatever they want to play. My opponent deck makes you feel very smart. I already explained and I ignore it. I didn't ignore it. I see everything. I'm like, you know, the parrot with the eyes on the cheeks. I see everything. I choose to not really give too much fuel because, but you seem like very dedicated to the cause. Some people usually just give up. But you, I must admit, you're holding. And then again, oh wow, Augur of Ball is breaking. Name a more iconic duo. Am I just baby sharking? I think so. Only one color can interact with the opponent. I mean, blue is the superior color, though. That's not just one color, it's blue. That's different. And we're playing a format that's like legacy, vintage, you know, modern. It's well known that blue is the superior color in Magic the Gathering since 1993. I think I'm passing here. Made my land drop. Like, thinking that you can have every choice, every like. Thinking that you can have every options available to you, it's just not really a fun Magic match. Blue is the best. Okay, I'm cycling. Shark Typhoon. They even gave us Brainstorm. I'm sure there's many effect that like Toccatli Honor Guard and Ashbringer. For example, just like two that came into the top of my mind. Although I only have one interaction here, which is commit. It's not much. Not much. So I think I'm passing. Nissa shakes the word as not blue. It isn't blue. Winning the game before you combo off is hard, because they can combo off on turn four. Okay, you cast Failed Wishes. It feels blue. What, Nissa feels blue? No, it's not blue. Alright, am I Shark in 3-3? Yeah, I think I am. Let's eat that Augur of Bolas. Opponent decided to tap out for a good old Failed Wishes pre-combat. We don't have, like, Lotus Petal. Bam! Take that, Augur of Bolas. Alright, let's play a Brainstorm since they drew a Fable Passage. I want to draw counters. Where are my counters? Porca puttana. I did draw a million shark typhoon, to be honest. Not the worst. Attack with all ear. If you want to chum block my 1/1, that's fine. Send 5 damage down, please. Unfortunately, I didn't draw that many counters in this game. So if they have the combo, I lose the game. Archon of Emeria. Yeah, exactly. Archon of Emeria is another stall piece. I know, Augur of Bolas. I love this card so much. Do you remember, Chad? We had like a week back in the days where I only had Augur of Bolas week. I don't know if somebody is in the chat here or is... used to watch me when I was playing with Word of Spark, but I loved Augur of Bolas. I always tried to play decks with Augur of Bolas. I played it in Pauper a lot. All right, more sharks. This deck draws so many sharks, by the way. I drew 4 Shark Typhoon in. And it didn't even feel like I did something wrong. I just drew 4 Shark Typhoon. Alright, so if I go Nisa, that's lethal, but I don't think that's what I want to do. Let's begin with the Abundant Harvesting non land. Die, I want the counters. Where are they? Oh, Kaboya. If I play Nisa and they counter, they can kill me the next turn. So we just don't have to do anything here. I remember, yeah, right? I remember that. Izzy Drakes. Izzy Drakes never hit. That card never hit with Izzy Drakes. I know, I remember that. And niente, we got a pass here. Unfortunately, if our opponent has the combo, we lose. But that's fine. We lose. Yeah, it gonna happen to somebody. I was hoping to draw at least one counter magic in this game, but we literally drew 0 in the top million card. We have currently 3 laps, 2 negate, 3 tails end. Did I play 1 laps? I didn't play 1 laps. How is this exiled? I'm putting exile. Oh yeah, Thoughtseize. Okay. Commit memory is a counter, I know, but it costs 4. Like, it's never gonna work. I can, but it's never gonna work. No, I mean, I can't go gross fire because I have the commit, but... like, it's turn a million, like, they for sure found the combo plus a backup counter. For sure. Can we please chill out about the whole pack discussion? Dirk, we can if you bring up a better topic. Would you play Nimble Mongoose? No, Nimble Obstructionist in the current historic meta. Me? Nimble Obstructionist? Is that the 3-1? Hello, Swai. Hello, Korea. Never been to Korea. One day I'll come. I will not give up on my Kaira. Kaira, la merda vera. I will not give up on Kaira. Sorry. Passa Oracle. Hey. Resolves. How many cards do you have? Una. Resolves. Resolve. Ah no, cazzo, perso. Alright, that was a punt. Alright, I'll think about this punt while I'm at the bathroom. Alright, we're back. Do I want to have any... do they have any red card? They show me any red card? Only Bone Crusher and Valkyr Awakening. Alright, then I'll cut the Aether Gust. Alright, I'll play first. Okay. We have the turn 2 Brainstorm Abundant Harvest if I draw another land. which I like. I think I changed my mind. I want to just do this for no land, top land, go. I guess I'll do this again. The life total doesn't matter. We're harvesting a lot. You like Mango's glasses? Yeah, I like them too. I should get a haircut, by the way. The hair is growing over the glasses here. I don't like it. Oh wow, point and sling search for Ascanta. Pretty sure that's illegal, but that's okay. Wow, there's so many. See, now I'm in the. Now I have too many answers and I don't have any threats. Cats. Not good. Can tell you this is not good now. I'll go get like island and then abundant harvest for non-land. Okay, Teferone Paperone at least. Then milling out. Yeah, Tail's End is good because you can win without much. Maybe I should have just not hide the land there. But yeah, I guess I wanted to draw like. That's fine. I don't even know what I wanted to draw. I think I'm gonna lose this game based on the fact that I don't have threats. I have this feeling now. My opponent is gonna outgrind me with their search and tome. Have I seen their crackling Drake combo? Oh wow, that's funny. Whirler Rogue and Kaladesh Remaster? Whirler Rogue is an like what, M19? Let's get this banned, it is. No, Cold Steel Art. I think I just memory lapsed this. Not that I don't want them to draw Cold Steel Art. You can have a Cold Steel Art. It's just that you want to trade a card for a card in my hand. Okay, please, please, please don't have Mystical Dispute. Please, don't have Mystical Dispute. Ah, que tilt! Merda, que tilt! When they have like this freaking one off deck and I just exactly Mystical Dispute. Ah! Ah! I still could have a Spell Pierce as well. No, now I don't have any threats. I'm gonna lose the search for Ascanta and Tome. Exactly, we even said please! We even said please! We even said please! Right? No, the remastered wasn't that. Remastered was. Alright, let's do the non-land here. Boom! I call my commit. How many cards do you have? 4. Okay! Bring to light. No, yeah, bring to light Valky could be a thing. It costs 5. I guess they don't want to make it more. Out of 4 months again. Okay, so the problem here is that don't think there's a problem. I'm going to commit the search. Wait, they foretold the card. Okay, it worked. Bene. I shock myself and pass the turn. I even have the Narset memory combo to win the game. Their Thomas expired. It was just a 4-for-1. No big deal. Just a 4-for-1. Yeah, hold on. Negate the search. I could have also Tails Ended, because that's legendary. I'll grow Spiral. Mossy, let's put this into play. No, Night and Fox. Behold. Yeah, again, I don't mind exchanging card for a card. I have memory over here. Our opponent just please go off. Please go off. Please go off. No, opponent doesn't go off. Okay, this is not bad. Let me have a clock on top of let me have a clock while leaving double counter up. Nakahira to end. Nakahira to end. Kahira can stay there. Please opponent go off. Now I have to hope that they go off and they only have one backup counter. If they go off and they have two backup counter, that's fine, you got me. I lose. But this game I didn't draw any Nissa. I think Nissa is just a key. I mean, they had to have Dispute there, or my Teferi would have resolved, and I think I would have won, but... Like, they just got so much card advantage this game. It doesn't matter about their combo, I'm just losing on a card advantage level. Like, the fact that they're playing a combo deck doesn't change it. Yeah, they probably will reprint Force of Negation though. Oh wow, they passed, not even make a land drop? I mean, not even make a land drop. How many lands do I have? I think I'm passing. I don't really care about Gaia at all. Gatto! Alright, I'll go Tail's End on this Narset. Attenzione, the land will fight for us. Will the land fight for us here? Will the land fight for us here? Gatto non graffiante. About getting unlucky? Wait, I'm not unlucky. Wait, you're pacting my Nissa? Makoma, you're pacting my Nissa. One sec, one sec. Allora, Pact of Negation counters my Nissa. No answer. Kaera, it's your time to shine. Pam. Opponent's gonna pay for the pact. Quintorius. Woo! And Shark Typhon. Now, feel like I just want a memory. Don't you guys feel like you want a memory? I wouldn't tap with 4 mana. The thing is that they have 7 cards. I see, can get so many flags. Let's go memory, chat. Let's go memory. Do we go for memory? I'm gonna go for memory. I wanna go for memory! Nice end, Mangu. Nice end. Nice end. They even redraw the Kyra. This is a nice hand. Look at this hand. Look at this hand. Just look at this hand. What a perfection! What a perfection hand. They're in 12. Why you might ask me, why did you do that? I did that because my opponent has 7 cards in hand, I had 3. Only one basic land left. Do you think so? Ernie Swamp. No, there's still two left. All right, I think I remember lapse this. They have 7 cards and they have 3. So like with that memory, it's like as I played like a tidings. I drew 4 cards. You do rest me. How about negate? Okay, so they don't have a counter because the auto topper went smooth. Ah, caboia. Va bene. They managed to find a lot of discard spell, unfortunately. Boom. That is something powerful. Yeah. Set to opponent. If you have the combo, I lose the game. Hopefully you don't have it. You don't have it. Don't have it. Don't have it. Don't have it. Don't have it, Jimmy Poopins. Jimmy Poopins. Time to die. It's fine. I have done everything in my power. And now it's up to you, opponent. Do you have your combo that's made of two cards and two cards? Did you use any previously? Nope. Mr. Poopins. Hello, Yellow Puppet. Mr. Poopins, do you have the combo? Do you need one more land for the combo? No, why'd you say that? Oh, someone's timing out? Solve the equation. Solve the equation resolves. Instant or sorcery? Instant or sorcery? Yeah, yeah, if they tainted pact. Sure, sure. Tainted pact with Sigurd Stormcaller wins. But it looks like they don't have it. I feel the victory. I'm tasting the victory here. Bon la victory. Have they made a land drop yet? I don't think they did. They're just taking for so long. They clearly don't have it. Seagate, taint the Seagate win, because you copy. The first time you... Oh, I see now. They're hoping that Tassa Oracle is the second to last. They're hoping that there's two Tassa Oracle at the bottom of the deck. This is their win condition now. But I don't think that the timer... I don't think they have enough time banks to do so. They're hoping that the bottom three cards of the deck, there's two Tassa Oracle in any combination. I do not do the math. I can't know the math, but I think that's their win condition now. The bottom three cards, there's to be any combination of two Tassa Oracle. The way you win with Sigurd Stormcaller Tainted Pact is that the first Tainted Pact gets you you just get two Tassa Oracle. No, you get one Tassa Oracle with the first, and with the second you deck yourself. Yeah, that's how you win. Alright, they're timing out. I don't think they can erase their timer right now. Oh, wow, it was almost there. Good game. It was almost there. They had two Tassa Oracle in the last five cards. Mangu wins! This is very good games. Very good games. I thought they would outgrind me this game. They had like Surge and Maze Mind Tome, but thankfully though. Did you really though? Glacial Fortress, welcome Glacial Fortress. Thank you for always be around with us. Did they win the turn? Yeah, I explained. They had a very thin win. Yorion? Yorion? Come here, Yorion! Hoodie! Yorion? Can I repeat it? Yorion? Alright, let's go Growth Spire main phase. Hated life. Wouldn't harvest. No land. Please, opponent, don't go Narset now. Don't go Narset now. I'm recommando, don't go Narset. Ah! Okay. What'd you get? Creation. Hey, I'm so jealous, opponent. I'm so jealous you get to do all this fun stuff. What is casting ultimatum, I feel like? I feel like their deck plays ultimatum. Yeah, Braska Golgari Queen. What card is that? Alright, okay, let's go Nissa. And tap in, the island. Cast this brainstorm. Unfortunately, I can't cast my counters. They didn't draw any brain pool or anything like that. Okay, opponent can go ultimatum here. Don't do it. Boring, Clex. Heh, you got it. Goodbye, Nissa. That's why I left the Wrath of God on top. I mean, it wasn't because of boring Clex necessarily, but mostly because, I don't know, they could have had something like similar to that. And they would have needed the Wrath of God there. 1 second. I feel like I want to get a forest. And then I'll pass without making a land drop. They didn't have a ultimatum earlier. And they had 7 mana, so... Now... Oh, I'm obviously behind. Explore, okay. Obviously behind. I'm gonna Tails End this Vraska Golgari Queen. Seek a Restoration. Yeah. That's good. Oh! Nah, yeah, I think I have to go Nissa. Despite I don't have the Tails End up, I feel like I have to go Nissa here. I should want to cycle this, because I might drop Radiant Pool. Oh wow, ultimatum. Let's see, because they don't have the Boring Clex anymore. I don't expect to win, but it's okay. Not that Tails End would have saved me from this ultimatum. Tails End is a... I mean... Ibalt e Professor Onyx, okay. Ibalt cannot kill Planeswalkers, nor does Professor Onyx. I wish I had a Tails End up. I could have countered one of these Planeswalkers. Good morning, Zmeds. Let's go! Oh, let me check. What do I have in my deck? Because my deck is pretty empty. My deck is not very... It doesn't have very many good cards at this point. Shadow Verdict. Let's do this. Yeah, I could have counter Planeswalker. Yeah. Commit is not bad. Again, my luck in not having a Breeding Pool or a Zagotrium is hurting me a lot in this game so far. Because I could have now had a Kahira plus Commit if I had a blue forest land. Allora, let's just go. Let's just go commit on Tybalt now. Commit on Tybalt. And then I can go attack Professor Onyx. Woman of the Sea, okay. There's Shadow Verdict to kill my lands, but it's okay. Scry top bottom. And then I'll activate. Well, I'm going to activate. Because opponent is going to kill my land here. After this, I will land to get. I think I want it to be a Temple Garden. And then I think I'll tap out to get back Aera. I don't think these won't do anything. And they're going to die here, so might as well. Why does I use the mana? They do have red. They don't have red mana to cast Tibalt. Interesting game. They have resolved ultimatum. They have resolved like 3-6 drop, but we're fighting. They got another ultimatum. I can go Kaya right here. Then I still have double kills end up. I could have countered Narset, it's just that I have the lane to kill it afterwards. And I only had one Tail's End. I wanted to protect myself from the Vraska, which I think is slightly better, I don't know. Sorry, Dirk. Yeah, I know I kind of have double Tails and up, but if you consider that my opponent has an ultimatum, they're gonna put two cards on the stack at the same time, so I might be able to double Tails End here. Not just two legends, you can also stifle if they get like, I don't know, Binding of the Old Gods. Oh, actually they can do that. If they cast Binding of the Old God, Tails End also works against that. Why Garden is a 4/4? Because Kyera makes the elemental +1/+1, and the land is a 4/3 elemental because of Nissa. Yeah, this happens so much. So much. Kyera helping your. This is why I play with a companion. I mean, playing with a companion is always going to be relevant, especially on a deck like this that sometimes just have a million mana and nothing to do. No. Kyera has wards. Kyera has wards. Obviously, it's not on the same like good level of Yorion. I mean, Yorion is very powerful, but Kyera is definitely relevant. Buff the pig. It used to buff also Krazes. I cut Krazes in the end, but there used to be Krazes in this deck. Yeah, it doesn't buff the shark, unfortunately. Looks like opponent's passing the turn. You love to see this. You love to see the timer running up for my opponent. Well, now I can either -8 Nissa, but then I don't have anything. I guess I have memory. How many forests does this deck even play? Doesn't play that many, right? I have two Triome. I have eight. I have nine forests that I'm getting. Do I want to do that? Probably not. This grid's better than Elder Gaga. Elder Gaga, you can't have Kyera in your companion. I don't want to give my opponent to 7 new cards, though. Why Krazes did not make the cut? Krazes was just another of those expensive cards, and the combination of Nissa and Teferi with the 2 mana interaction is just too good that I prefer having those. We're impressed by emblems. Yeah, emblems. It's funny how they never got rid of emblems. There is not a single magic card in the history of the game since, I want to say Lorwyn, that interacted with the game. At no point I killed my Nissa and your land with these two planeswalkers, because are you not missing? Okay, my opponent, I think, timed out, so we won on that regard. Not the prettiest of the win. I think I would have probably lost the game. Anyway, I always make sure, I think that on the client, if you're from computer, you can see my opponent cards. You go in their graveyard and you can read the cards, Professor Onyx, and you can read the card Tibalt, so you know like exactly what's going on. Magic is sometimes overwhelming. Too many things going on. I try to, cover them all, but I'm sure that most people will miss out something. Unfortunately, this is not a keepable hand. Sometimes you have these hands like this, where Plains plus Gurt Spiral makes you die internally, but it is. Thank you, Glacial Fortress, for never leaving. Never leave Mengu. I don't know what I would do without you. You got somebody thinking limited? I mean gold, and everyone just seems so strong. Oh, Mono Black. Mono Black! Looks like a tough matchup. At least I'm on the play. What mechanic? Would you wish to return Morbid or Revolt? If Revolt is more clear, right? But yeah, Glacial Fortress, definitely. Nah, let's just basically cast Memory Lapse on anything here, like. Yeah. I'll pass again. You can Thoughtseize me, it's okay. Yeah, I'm not doing anything. You can Thoughtseize me. Ooh! C'est bien! Oh! Lend. Fight for us. Sometimes I think about when you usually play 3 mana and put a companion into play. I think about those times sometimes, and I'm like, alright, it's time to do some cleaning over here. Get out. That's very large. Ooh! Wait, do you see what I'm seeing? Do you see what I'm seeing, or do I see what I see you don't see? I think I don't see what you see, chat. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but we are seeing two different things right now. Maybe the next things that you see. Alright, because it's important to understand. Like, I can't. I don't want to cycle now to 4-4 because I can just speed up push it. But I also maybe don't want to play Thoughtseize because they can just play Shark Typhoon because they can just Thoughtseize my Nissa and then I just want to cry. But they don't have Thoughtseize, they have to draw it. You hyped us for nothing. Did I hype you for nothing? Or am I going to actually cast the Shark Typhoon? Va bene, I'll do it! I'll do it. No, actually, I think it's the correct play. I think that's the correct play. Alright, please don't have a Thoughtseize on my Nissa. Eh? No Thoughtseize, please? Oh, Castle is not bad. Directional Blade Raider. Come on, Oscar. Okay. And now they can like push or Artless Act my shark. Yep. I think this play played better around a removal spell. Cause now I could have just drawn a cantrip. Cause like if I quit stop whenever deals damage. Whenever a source deals damage. So if I double block, I have to sacrifice 7 permanent. Sacrificing 7 permanent usually doesn't play very well. I'm going to 2 here, and I just hope to top deck a Wrath of God. And then give up. Alright. Good game. Good game, Mono Black. Always a pleasure to play against Mono Black. What if I just cyber dot every interaction I have and just only stay on the ground? I think that's a good plan. Does it matter if we got to our cast? Yeah, I don't think I could have beat a removal spell any way I played that game. If the way I played make me able to play with like a top deck, you know, Abundant Harvest, Brainstorm, Gurt Spiral, then I would have been able to make a 2-2 and chump block the. Then yeah, and I wouldn't be able to chump block anything. Both of the threats at Trample, I was dead that game. No, Stunflare. No, pick only blocks activate ability, that's a triggered ability. Alright, play first. Thank you, Clutch of Fortress. Man, what would my life be without Clutch of Fortress? I don't know. Land. Like, imagine if you weren't playing with this card and your mana base was much worse. Alright. Agonizing Remorse. You don't see that very often. I appreciate it, my opponent isn't play with the yellow art on the cards. Thank you so much. Oisho. Okay, land for Mango, please. Ah, I said land, not 5-drop for Kaboya. That's a disaster. What did you discard? Imagine if I had land for a pig. It would have been so good. Such a bad turn here. No, actually, let's play Grip Spiral. If I draw Brainstorm, I'm casting. Ay. Land! Ah! Okay. Planes! Alright. Okay. I feel like between today and the past days, I've been in the spot where I need one win for Mythic and I lose at least 5 times. At least 5 times I need one win for Mythic and I lose. Okay, let's go. Bigger water bottle? No. I don't buy bigger water bottle. It's perfectly fine to go to stand up and refill. You know, not everyone needs bigger thing. You can just do the same thing twice. Bigger thing, or you know, you can just. It's not good to get bigger things. Sultai is the new way. Sultai is the new way. Could be the Sultai is the new way. Am I playing limited today? No, I'm not. Limited too hard for me. I'm a filthy historic gamer. Hunt of Vanguard. Hunt of Vanguard. Limited needs a big brain. I don't have that for stream. On stream, I click buttons. I click the space bar. Plus, whenever I draft, I just have to rare draft. That actually hurts my chances a lot. What percentage is your vault now? I don't know. Must be a lot, though. Alright, let's commit. Well, this game is pretty straightforward. I could commit now, Narsa later, and then memory the turn after. Gigantosaur. Alright, that plan is not working anymore. Let's start with the Narset. I'm bitching, no, sorry. I was meant to say let's start with Growth Spiral. Man, look, think about my brain. See, this is why I can't play the other deck there. Alright. Matteo, take the Fibone Paperone. And I'll pass. Glitch King, exactly. I like it. I like this deck. Like, the bad matchup that these decks have are like, whoa, Vito, Angel, Mono Black, like decks that I don't think are particularly strong. So I'm okay if I have a matchup that's... Tio Bono! Angel Reveals! No, no, because I'm not hiding anything. When's the last time I've hid... When's the last time I've hid something? I only hid my precious Magic the Gathering card in my house. That's the only thing I hide. I mean, I totally understand you guys feel like, well, Mango, this deck is awful. You should change deck. That's true. Certainly. But I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it because you know what I'm doing here? I am hard casting the Shark Typhoon. Boom. Boom, 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 boom. Losing again. I'm gonna say that there is correlation between me are casting the Typhoon and losing the game on the spot. Dead. No, maybe not. Maybe not. Die. Wrath of God for Mengu. I even have double white pony. You certainly cannot cast another Death Shadow. Certainly can't. I have a Breath of God. In my hand, I can tell you, opponent. In my hand, I have a Breath of God. Oh, yeah, I'm dead. I want to play Teferone Paperone. Do I want to tick it up or tick it down? Up or tick it down? Up or down? Up, up or down? Down, up or down? Up or down? If I go down, down. I kind of want to go down, chat. No, you don't want to go down? I think I want to go down, down. Up and down, down. Down, down. 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 Because now I can just take the damage, block the ranger, and my opponent can die to a Nissa this way. I could have, you know, up and played Memory Lapse. Oh, well, they're dead to my 5-5 shark if they don't do anything. And clearly they do something. In fact, I die. But that was a good game. I mean, I cast a Shark Typhoon. If you cast the Shark Typhoon, your chances to win drop of like 50%. If my chances were already low, then means I'm dead. Nothing's lol. Hello. Okay. Chat. We need to put up some show here. Where people watching Mango are like, wait, does this guy only loses? Mostly that's what happens these days. Mango09 only loses. There used to be a time where I was fighting, but then the rabbit stole it all. It is the rabbit's fault. We need it for Vog. We need for Vog. Exactly, we do need for Vog. Can I use Rakdos Dreadhorn? You can. You can. The rabbit. With a hat? I don't know if they had a hat. I just know that they had a rabbit. Was I doing better with Phoenix? Yes, but Phoenix felt like I wasn't. Phoenix was fun. But the thing is that, like, I don't want to repeat this again because it's the third time, but I feel like all my opponents deck that I just lose so hard against are not really decks that are popular, you know what I mean? Maybe I shouldn't do this play, maybe I should just save more of my life total. Bye, bye, bye. Offlink end. I'm gonna go no land on this. Next one, I'm gonna go land on this. I know ice for a cake, but that's just what I tell myself, you know? Like, that's not necessary. I don't have proof of that. I was supposed to get land there. Alright, I'm very happy I drew a land here. I'm going to cycle one my shark and block. Lovestruck Beast. I do understand what you mean, but I don't think Historic is a format where you can just have Lovestruck Beast and think that aggro deck just die to it. Like, the aggro deck I'm losing to are going way over the top of a 5-5. Like, Angels went way over the top of a 5-5. The Monoblef from earlier, that went like Obliterator, Spawn of Man, you know? This deck went like double shadow, triple shadow, insanely huge. I can't cast Wrath of God if you're wondering. I'm gonna go Abundant Harvest for non-land. Hoping to get a Baffling End here. I find the Brain Stonks, but now I have to go Baby Shark and chum block the Death Shadow. Death Shadow can, like, it's not gonna one-shot me, but close. That's fine, let's keep on playing, like, you don't have to base your testing around, you know, few losses on the diamond ladder. To choose if you want to bring the deck to a tournament. Nice. Now, opponent's gonna pay 4 life to save the Adant of Anger to my Wrath of God. I hope they don't have, like, Ranger of Eos. Ah, cazzo, they have it. Am I testing for a tournament right now? Yes, tomorrow I have to send the deck lists for my MPL weekend, which, just whatever tournament, but it's kind of like what I do. Okay, here I have to brainstorm to shuffle away these 2 lands. Definitely drawing those now, but that's okay. So I can shuffle away these 2 lands, go get Plains, Wrath of God. That's a good suggestion, Scar. Very good suggestion. I guess comes on like clicking buttons and playing terribly these days. Esper Doomfort to the standard, yeah, that's the only deck. I could have lost the game, maybe. I don't know. What are the chances that I play Goblins in the tournament? 0% chances. I have reached a stage in my life where I have a moral compass right now. And I would never do such thing anymore. You know, back in the days, I was playing for win. Now, I don't do that anymore. Okay, this is good here. Thank you, Scar. Is it called Moira Compass? Maybe it's not called Moira Compass, and I just made it up. Tarmogoyf? Did they announce that? Funky unit? Thank you, Scar. I appreciate the support. No. No. Thank you so much, Scar. It's a 12-12! Opponent reanimated the 12-12 and a 1-1. Land? Katsu! We're doing it! We're doing it here! Your friend Mango Zeronove is doing it. Can't remember last time I've won a game, but that feels like it's happening now. Oh, I won a game. I believe it was like an hour since I won one of my last games. Why do people think Goblin is evil? Because people usually enjoy playing Magic the Gathering. Someone don't. That's fine. Thank you, Scar. Okay, a black white. I feel like Memorlapse isn't the worst. Let me just sideboard on Narset. Magic is a zero sum game. Zero sum game? What does that mean? Yeah. Just blowing up lands is very fun for me too. I know, right, that did. I was just joking. Just joking. You know, I don't have a. I am not Magic Esports. I can joke about Tron players and Goblin players without being flamed. All right, you duress me Abundant Harvest? No, poor Abundant Harvest. Would you duress that card? Oh yeah, is that one's were so bad? Is the new Simic Planeswalker unplayable? It is unplayable, in fact. Oh, wow, Thalia. Metalia. Metalia. Thalia. The Guardian of Thraben. I love Thalia. Yeah, Jed, that is what I believe as well. Especially now that tournaments are actually not fun to play because you're not along with friends and etc. You just really have to enjoy what you're doing. But oh, it's Spellbinder! Alright, I think I have to do the Desperation Brainstorm to hide Shark Typhoon. I think whenever a Spellbinder discards the Shark Typhoon, it's just forever. They got it. I just keep. Oh, crying! I'm crying! I'm crying! Although. Mana's Dredge. Yeah, exactly, Wargross. People just enjoy different things. Exactly, I care about fun. Yeah, that's the thing. Yeah, we love to play different decks. That's why the what is called the Pack deck. The new Pack deck is hey. Alright, Zagatrium. You thought that if we shuffled away, you thought wrong. You thought wrong! Zagatrium. Thought that I would have shuffled it away, but no, I care about you, Zagatrium. Not surely I'm not shuffling away, but I'm going to redraw you right now, singing Beyoncé song. You thought wrong! Ooh, look at this, Yasharn only costs 4 mana. Can you please not discard my Yasharn too? Die, no, don't touch my Yasharn. Oh. Bello lì, bello, I pick all, I pick all. I think a 4-mana 4-4 getting two lands. Basic, that just comes away on tap. It feels so good. 5-mana memory lapse? No, I don't 5-mana memory lapse. Three mana. Alright, knight. You can come across. I'm not gonna sacrifice my pig for that. I usually prefer to sacrifice my pig for like more important occasions. For example, like Christmas lunch, Easter lunch, stuff like that. Not for a knight of the Abelegion. You're not that important. Arr, Kamadoska, this Ranger of Eos. Ranger of Eos so strong. Look how bad is my hand. Look how bad it is, my hand. Bad joke? Wait, why do you say bad joke? Ooh! Attenzione. I think I'm cool here. No land. I'll pass. I think I'm going to go exclamation mark lose. Exclamation mark lose chat. It's a very premature exclamation mark lose, but that's when I like to call them. That's when I like to call them. Wow, that's a lot. A lot of messages, top-notch Twitch chatter. Interesting attack there. Oh, why you got me? Attenzione. Attenzione, chat. Big question here, though. Do I attack or not? Do we attack or not? I don't think I want to attack here. Because, like, I want them to damage themselves with if near dead lands. Well, if they attack, I'm just snapping the double block. Fastest double block ever. They don't have a land, so they can't pump and play Thoughtseize. So if they only pump, that's fine. And then I'm wrathing. And then I have Nissa left with nothing on board. Thoughtseize costs 2 mana. They don't have that. I guess they can go Selfless Savior to save, like, whatever they want to save. But I'm fine. This also meant that I got rid of my Wrath of God in hand for that thing. So let's go Vogue here. Free attack. If you put them on 11, they can cast Death Shadow, whereas now they can't. I can return Kahira. Then I can untap the forest and pass. Can cast Kahira, but I'd rather not. I'd rather leave the blocker. I have a blocker, easy. See, now they have to damage themselves, which is better. They cast Thoughtseize. I think I'm gonna make you another lapse on that Thoughtseize. And now, so you see, Death Shadow now is uncastable. And they attacked earlier, they would have been able to cast Death Shadow. Death Shadow there. Sharky? Sharky. Not one shark, but two sharky. Allora, remember that if you have shark in play and you cast this Abundant Harvest, despite to spend 4 mana on it, it's still like making a 1-1, which isn't bad, I'm just saying that. And again, I could like not, I could play Kahira and knock an attack for 8, you go down to 5. And then how big is the shark? See, that's a winning line. That's a winning line. That's for sure a winning line. That's for sure a winning line. Man, this exclamation mark lose I said was so premature and I loved it. Was such a premature exclamation mark lose. Probably one of my most premature exclamation mark lose I've ever done. Now, opponent's on 5. I think I saw that shot in the world, but my shark typhoon will eat them here. Good game. Alright, with this win, this is the comeback. This is the beginning. This is the beginning of the comeback. Thoughtseize? Tant'è così. Say. I can just, it's fine to do it. Yeah, it's fine to do it. 5. 7, vero? Sì. So I'll go with 5. It's on 5. Oh, I guess they could have done it 3. Because they go to 3. Whatever. PAM! Woo-woo-woo! Well, that's your face to... I don't know, Alberto. That's the tough part. Not aggro decks. I think Jund Sacrifice is good. I think Jund Sacrifice is one of the good decks. Alright, I have to go to the bathroom super quick. I want to play this deck more.
I like this deck. I like its flaw. This just fits my game plan. I enjoy playing it. I don't care if it's not good against green white angels or other strategies. I enjoy playing this deck. This was a nice game. This was a nice game. All right, I'll be back in a minute and then we play more. Ha ha ha.